Welcome back to Fallout 4. There seems to be some sort of an emission storm going on, almost kind of reminiscent of the Stalker series, although not quite as severe. Because I was standing out here and, yeah, see, I just got some radiation. And everything looks all foggy and nasty, and there's some crazy storms going on. It's really eerie. Guess it's not a good time to travel. But anyway, okay, so just to catch you up on what I'm going to do and a couple things that I've done. I had a point to spend in my skills, so I went ahead and spent it on Gun Nut, which gives me access to base level and rank 1 gun mods. So then, after doing that, I went to modify my guns to see if that would allow me to create anything new and cool, and indeed it does. So this is my main...
I'll hand it to you. This place isn't awful. It's still a hole, but it could be worse.
Thanks, Marcy. So this is the main sniper rifle that I'm using. One of the things I can do is change out the short scope for a medium scope, which seems to be basically the same as the short scope, except better. It's a little bit heavier than the short scope. That's a tiny bit of the weight, but that seems to be the only negative. So let's go ahead and do that. Preston liked that. I'm glad you approve of my weapon mods, Preston. I'm still not taking you into my group, though. So, that is done. Oh god. Huh, maybe it doesn't matter if I'm outside or not, because I just got radiation and this is undercover. Anyway, so I've got two quests right now. I have a kind of side quest, Raider Troubles at Oberlin Station, which is to help out the settlement over there, and then Jewel of the Commonwealth, which is to go to Diamond City, and that's my main quest. So I was taking a look at where this Raider Trouble thing is. It's right here. And as it turns out, Diamond City is just a little bit further down the way. So I might as well go here to try to help out the settlers along the way to Diamond City. But of course, let's be realistic. Look at this. I am here. That is there. There's like 2 million things in between here and there. So most likely I'm not even going to get to the settlers at Oberlin Station in this episode. It's an open world game. Come on, it's not going to happen. So let's just go adventuring. I think I'll pop over to the Museum of Freedom, and probably just go about straight south from there and just see what I find. Oh, what'd you find, boy? A hard hat. Aww. Thank you. I've already got a hat, but let's not tell him that. Let's let him feel good. I love it. I love the hard hat. I am going to wear it. Tonight, every single night I go to sleep, I'm just going to wear it. Makes me feel comfortable and protected. Okay, so straight south? Yeah, let's go south. Oh, let's check out the scope, too. Ah, cool. Definitely more magnification, I think. Although, to be honest, I don't really like the actual, like, pointer part very much. I'm not really sure where it's going to shoot. Is it going to shoot above the point, but at the line? Is it going to shoot, like, above the point or, like, at the point? I don't really get it. Yeah, the sights, the magnification's good, but the actual sights, the design of the sight, or whatever you want to call the design that tells you where the shot is actually going to go, is actually pretty crappy. Ah, well. There's a tent or something this way. Let's go see what that is. According to the compass. I like this eerie fog. It's really cool looking. Bugme found an enemy. Oh. Someone nearby. Who do we have? Look like a mutant to me. Gorski Cabin. It's a cabin in the woods with a mutant inside. And I missed. Nice. Smooth one. Perfect. Intended. Oh, I'm stuck in a tree. This is not the weapon for this. God, they're so fast! Get him, dog meat. You know, the more I think about it, the more I think my current... like, my current setup of having a long-range rifle and then kind of a shorter-range burst rifle, I think that's a pretty good setup. Because I want my main weapons to be rifles, since that's where I get my damage bonus in. You know, the plus 20% damage when using non-automatic rifles. So I want to use probably only rifles and nothing else. I want to specialize in them. But I definitely can't just use a long, you know, a weapon like this that shoots really slowly from a long distance. This just doesn't work when enemies are up in your face. So I think what I've got going on right now is pretty good. Except I think I should actually change the scope out for a reflex sight, because it's not very good for when you're trying to shoot enemies close to you. That like half-second black pause when you go to zoom in is really distracting when enemies are up in your face. So I think I'm going to modify this weapon next time I'm at a station. But I like the idea of having a fast-firing weapon for close-up enemies, but still a rifle. And then a slower-firing rifle for enemies far away. Oh, are you friendly? Oh no, you're not friendly. Come on. Hit. There we go. I feel kinda bad. I mean, it's a feral ghoul, yeah, but... it was just trying to sleep. Wooden block. I and D. Just a couple letter wooden blocks. Cool. Chemistry station. I don't think I've ever found one before. I found cooking stations, but what can I make? Drugs. Wow. I just come out of the vault. Like, what am I? I mean, aren't I like a housewife with a law degree? Like a housewife with an old law degree? That's what I was before the apocalypse, and now I come out of the vault and I can make drugs and plant crops and I'm the general of the Minutemen. Like, Jesus. I'm going places. I don't think I'd need any drugs, no thanks. Can't make any grenades. Can't make any healing stuff. Mines. Jesus, I can't make anything. Cutting fluid. I don't get it. What does that do? What does it cut? Like, locks? Can I open safes? Regardless, I can't make anything. I keep thinking in terms of Stalker, because in the Stalker series, cars are a really good source of loot. There's often things in them or on the back of them or little hidden caches everywhere. But in this game, the cars aren't really used to store stuff that much. Okay, according to the compass, over in this direction there's like a slice of lasagna with a bunch of, like, fingers coming out of the lasagna, like a, maybe like a lasagna zombie is breaking its way out of the lasagna dirt, coming back to life. So let's go see what that is. Oh, it's a pond. That makes more sense. Danger. What's on me? Oh. I didn't even see those things. I said caution, so I think there's something else around here, nearby. There's gunshots. Oh, they're coming from up there. Is that an enemy? What are you? What are you? Raider. There's another one. It says they're up above. I don't see them, though.
No need to hide. It'll all be over soon.
He's right. It was over soon. How much weight do I have? 164 to 220. I could take a little bit of armor if I want, but I probably won't. I got a paintbrush. Can I be the Bob Ross of the Wasteland? Can you make a character that looks like Bob Ross in the character creator? Because that would be amazing. Probably nasty stuff in here. Maybe more of those soft-shell mire lurks? Going for a swim, dog meat. Have fun. There's gotta be something here, right? Something. Kickball. Reds. I see light. Might be somebody in there. Automated tour? Sure.
Hello, and welcome to Walden Pond. You are now standing in front of the cabin inhabited by transcendentalist writer and philosopher, Henry David Thoreau, starting in the summer of 1845. For 2 years, 2 months, and 2 days, Thoreau lived in this cabin, hoping to gain a more objective understanding of society. This experiment was influenced by Thoreau's interest in transcendentalist philosophy, which believed that people were at their best when truly self-reliant. By living off the land with few material possessions, Thoreau proved it skeptical to think that any outward improvement of life could bring inner peace and contentment. For more information, please visit the gift shop and purchase one of the many books on transcendentalism.
Here's the gift shop.
Also available, t-shirts, coffee mugs, toys, and many other items to commemorate your trip.
See if we can pick up any commemorative artifacts.
Thank you for visiting Walden
Pond. Antique globe, sure.
Sponsored by General Atomics, maker of the Mr. Handy robotic assistant.
Oh my god, no. No. Oh! That's a bomb. Well, whatever. We have bigger issues. Ah, there we go. Okay, I should probably heal myself. Eat some more of my baked stuff. Mole rat chunks. Yeah. You know, my radiation's getting pretty high. I should probably take some rad away. Or rad X. Is it rad away or rad X? Rad away, yeah. There we go.
That's it.
A postman uniform. Could be a postman of the apocalypse. Let's see what it looks like. And what am I wearing right now? Laundered rose dress? Yeah. Also, let's check out the winter jacket and jeans. Looks, well, functional. Now let's try the postal uniform. You even get a US mail bag. Oh my god, that is so cool. I'm gonna wear this for a bit. I'm a US postal delivery person with a mining helmet on and a bandana. Oh. Don't feed the bears. Anything on the roof? It looks like it's a log bridge. Look at that! Neato. Dog food, too. Note to Tweeze. Tweeze, if you're reading this, then you're an idiot. This is the last time I tell you. We're locking this door. Use the entrance in the sewer pipe. Next time you forget, I'm locking your ass out permanently. Walter. Locked. Use entrance in the sewer pipe. Okay, so there's an entrance in a sewer pipe somewhere.
Lock's really strong.
Let's find this pipe. Empty blood sack. That is disgusting. What, am I gonna reuse that? That can't be safe. Okay, sewer pipe. How far away would it be? Probably not this far. Oh, here we go. This has got to be it. Yeah. Gift shop basement. Probably gonna meet Tweeze in here, I'm guessing. Let's be all sneaky-like.
So this guy made sure he had everything.
There's Tweeze.
He needed before he started his camping trip in that little shack up top. Double-checked his list and everything. And that's why they call it being the rogue.
And this guy invented transdentalism,
moron. You sound like an idiot.
How the hell you know all this?
I read a book that one time. When we ran out of grognacks.
I wish I could read.
You're not actually an enemy, are you?
Hmm.
Oh wait, no, you are! I thought he would have discovered me by now, damn. You didn't mean to hit the body. Heard a voice. There's more. More down here. I am the king now. I'm your new US mail delivery person overlord. And I'll mine your souls. For fun. I don't sound very convincing, do I? I don't think they're intimidated.
Hey!
No! Don't!
eye on me!
Gift shop key. Bayoneted tuned pipe bolt action pistol. That sounds pretty good. I don't really use my pistol anymore, but let's take a look at it. Because in case I do use my pistol, I think I'd prefer to use that one. So this is my current one. Let's see how it compares. More damage. A lot more damage, like double the damage. Fire rate is garbage, though. Yeah, the fire rate is terrible. I can't use a pistol at that low of a fire rate. Its fire rate is 3 compared to my sniper rifle's fire rate of 2. It's only slightly better. It's only slightly faster at firing than my sniper. Nuka-Cola, I don't even think that would have fit inside. That's weird. I'll take a duplicate mining helmet in case this one gets damaged. Alright, let's keep heading to our destination. Such a cool looking bus. Slightly space age. Oh, hello. Guy's wearing like a sack on his head. Yeah, a sack hood with hoses. Am I overweight? Oh, I am. That's why I can't run. Shit. What do I need to dump? Sort by weight. Oh my god, these mining helmets are super heavy. 5. Let's dump one of them. Guess I'll dump some weapons, too. This thing weighs almost 10. Oh, this is not a bloatfly. Or whatever the stingy things were before. How many flying things have I seen? Is it just bloatflies? Well, regardless, I'm not sure if I've seen this thing before. Shoot its wings! You suck. Alright, forget that. Okay. That thing's surprisingly tough. When did I last save? Ah, just right here, thank god. Gonna sneak up on that thing and headshot it in its tiny, buggy head. Where is it? Oh, there it is. And it sees me. come on. It's really hard to hit. Is there another one? Fuck me. Yep, there's another one. Alright, hold on. What just happened? Did the Stingwing just, like, trigger an explosive? I don't know, but I don't hear it anymore, so I think it is dead. Alright, more food. So there are explosives around here. I guess the Stingwing did trigger one of them. That's why this place is protected. Fusion core. Something right over here. Like a factory? I don't think that's supposed to be poking out. ArcJet systems. Cool, let's check it out. Power's out. I wonder if I can restore the power. If I could restore the power, where would I do it? In the main factory building, I suppose? Probably. See what adventures await us. Seems like a pretty big place. Well, this definitely has power. So I wonder why the side building doesn't. There's gotta be people in here, right? There's gotta be. Let's stay on the ground floor first. Can I get through the window? Doesn't seem like it. Can take the table knife, though. Oh shit, they're shooting at dog meat. No, dog meat! Turret! Dog meat!
And order has prevailed. All hit right there.
Holy shit. That thing. Oh, turret. That thing has a lot of health, too. Let me see if I have like a mine I can put down, because it's probably gonna come through the doorway in just a minute. Bottle cap mine. Or fragmentation mine? Let's see. Damage 101. Damage 301. Let's go with damage 301. Is it coming? Yeah, it's coming. Good. There we go. Come on, please work. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come around the corner. There we go. There we go. Come here. Come on. Yes! Nice! I'm proud of myself for that one. That was clever. Do I have any more cooked stuff? Purified water, that's fine. Yeah, sugar bombs, Blamco, mac and cheese, all that stuff has rads. I think I need to do some more cooking, aside from the Deathclaw steak, which restores an obscene amount of HP. So much so that it feels like a waste to use it. But aside from that, I think I'm out of cooked stuff. Bubblegum? Even the bubblegum gives you rads.
Unidentified intruder detected.
Oh, there's more Protectrons? Search. Of course there's more.
Area secure.
Gwinnett Pilsner bottle. What the heck is that? Jawless Brahmin skull. Why was that in the trash? Overdue book. How do I know it's overdue? It's actually not weak in the head, it's actually hard in the head. Or at least the back of the head. Let's try to cripple its arm, I suppose. I don't even know if this game has crippling.
Escape attempts. Lawbreaker. Do not be alarmed.
Shit. You know, I think it's time for that steak. Yeah, there's crippling. I shot off its arm. Oh, dog meat! Oh, I can stimpack you. Good. Come here, dog meat. You're good, you're good. You're good, boy. There you go. The disarm is, like, orange, reddish. I assume that means it's hard? And there's a chance it's gonna blow up in my face. Oh, seemed to work. Let's not let you out. You're an asshole.
That's it.
Quick-handed pipe pistol. That thing's nasty looking. Look at that blade on the end. Leaded welded Raider right arm. Sounds like a really nicely upgraded right arm piece. Let me take a look and see if it's better than what I've got. That's not it. There you are. Yeah, significantly better stuff. Better stats, I mean. Oh, wait, that... Oh, well... Not exactly what I was going for. Alright, let's change into something that actually has armor, shall we, then? The dress is really nice, and I wish I could wear that, like, over proper armor, but it seems like you can't. So let's put on some proper stuff. Let's sort by... value, I suppose? Should give me the best stuff on top. Jumpsuit's really the best, alright. Will that replace the arm, though? Oh, no, it doesn't. Okay, good. So let's see if anything else has better stats. Summer shorts. Hard hat. That does have better stats, but I want to keep my mining helmet because of the light. Right leg. Does that replace my armor? No, okay. Left leg? Sure. Worse, worse. Left arm? Pop that on. Okay. There we go. I look... interesting. Well, let's be honest, I look like a mess. I've got a vault jumpsuit, I've got a weird piece of, like, rebar stuck on one side of my shoulder. Different thing on the other side, I've got a bandana. Glasses. Mining helmet. I am a fashion nightmare. But that's fine.
Hell yeah.
Energy weapons permanently inflict plus 5% critical damage. Ooh, that's some good stuff. And that auto pistol sounds pretty neat. Let's take a look at that thing. Look at that fire rate. I'm gonna take that instead of my current pistol. Let's test this thing out. It is automatic. Gonna blow through that ammunition in minutes. CEO's terminal. Holy shit. Alright, let's dig in. What were you up to at the ArcJet Systems? Marshop Project Notes. After 6 months, the United States Space Administration finally approved ArcJet as a contractor for the Marshot Project's propulsion and communications systems. Having my team start working on the XMB booster before we secure the contract was a gamble, but it looks like it's going to pay off big. We have a lot of details to hash out with the agency, and we have a lot of work ahead of us, but I think this contract will finally put ArcJet on the map. So they're contractors to the government. It's a sweet contract to get. I was fortunate to be able to find Dr. Rory McClellan, Dr. Rory McClellan to the XMB booster team today. There are a few people who can match Dr. McClellan's aptitude with nuclear propulsion systems. So this truly was a coup. It cost the company a heck of a lot of money to hire him away from his military contracting job, but I'm sure it will be well worth every dollar. We promised the USSA that the booster would be ready at least a year before the July 2078 launch date. With Dr. McClellan at the helm, we should be able to meet that deadline with time to spare. As the holiday season approaches, it's time to take a step back and look at everything that's happened to ArcJet Systems this year. 5 months ago, my company was struggling to make ends meet. Now with the XMB booster and the deep range transmitter projects in full swing, ArcJet appears to have received a second chance. Thanks to Dr. McClellan, we're on schedule and under budget. The USSA is thrilled with our progress and is already talking to me about future contracts after we deliver. I don't think it's possible to be ending the year on a better note. Well, good for them. I'm guessing something's gonna go wrong though. This is 3 months after the last note. Dr. McClellan's informed me that we have a problem with the XMB booster. The USSA is demanding that the engine can't exceed their strict weight allowance. But thanks to the uranium refinement subsystem, we're a few hundred tons over. We're now 1 month behind schedule, and I'm frankly starting to panic. Dr. McClellan assures me he'll find a solution soon, but that isn't helping me get to sleep at night. The USSA has started their public relations campaign for the Mars Shot project, and ArcJet Systems is finding itself caught right in the middle. In the last week, I think I've fielded 15 separate interviews with everyone asking the same questions over and over again. They all want to know when we're delivering the XMB boosters so they can take their pretty pictures of the USSA test firing it for the first time. And all I can do is keep smiling and lying through my teeth that the XMB will be delivered when it's ready. I hope Dr. McClellan solves our weight problem soon, or we're never going to get a contract from the USSA ever again. I can't believe it, but Dr. McClellan's team finally solved the XMB's weight problem. Now all we need to do is finish tightening a few screws and hoist the thing up into the engine core. If we're lucky, we'll be able to test fire the booster right after the new year. It's funny how things seem so bleak and chaotic during the year, but it all comes together for us just in time for the holidays. We've scheduled a photo opportunity tomorrow for the XMB booster's first test firing in the engine core. We're going to stick them all down in the control room and let them shoot their pictures through the thermoglass window after Dr. McClellan gives them a short explanation of how the booster works. The engine puts out a hell of a lot of thrust, so it should be quite a spectacular show. It's been 2 weeks since the accident before the XMB booster's test firing event. Somehow, a photographer managed to wander past security and into the engine core a few hours early. Dr. McClellan was running a quick test on the booster, letting it run for only a few seconds to make sure it was ready for the demonstration, and burned the photographer into ash. Thank God no one else saw what happened. I'm having Brent take care of the remains. After all, that's why I hired him. If word of this accident goes public, we'll be shut down and I may as well put a for sale sign out front. Oh God, that's horrible. Can you really blame ArcJet for killing that person, though? They were somewhere they should not be. I mean, someone basically breaks in. I mean, I guess they didn't break in, but if someone wanders somewhere they shouldn't be. I mean, I don't know, it depends on the safety precautions, you know, was the door locked? Was there reasonable security to stop them from going into the place that was so dangerous? All of the unrest overseas is making the USSA nervous about proceeding with the Mars Shot project. They're telling me they may have to delay a year or more, depending on what happens. If that's true, we'll just have to make do with the proceeds from the deep-range transmitter contract, which we've already completed. I'm trying to keep everyone's spirits up around here, but it's getting harder and harder with the world falling apart around us. Hopefully, our government will work things out and we can all get back to work. And then the apocalypse happened. Repair department terminal. Ooh. Oily. Likeliness 1. That can't be it. That can't be it. Can't be it. Could be it. Can't be it. Could be it.
Yes.
Repair orders. Turret control. Alright, let's do that first. Let's turn off the turrets. Deactivate. Okay. Repair order, whatever, blah blah blah. Installed new terminal in Reinhardt's office. He's demanding some serious security on it now that we've got the Mars Shot contract. I'm not sure if he's being paranoid or if he's got a real reason to worry. I'll set him up with the best we've got for now. Okay, now I'm convinced Reinhardt is paranoid. He's had me put in automated security turrets in the main hallway outside his office. You'd think we were working for the military instead of just the United States Space Administration. Got McClellan constantly bugging me that the mainframe keeps running out of space. I've ordered some more storage from our supplier, but we're rapidly running out of room down here for any more consoles. I might have to talk Reinhardt into letting us spill over into the office sections. Shouldn't be too much of a problem. Brent came down and had me pull all of the video surveillance records from the mainframe from the last month. I asked if he wanted me to just make him backups, but he just grunted like he always does and demanded the originals. I have no idea what he's doing with them, and I don't want to know. As long as I keep getting a paycheck, I could care less.
He should have said, I couldn't care less.
But it's okay, I forgive you. Yes, that was him pulling the security cam footage of the photographer being turned into ash. Okay, I think it's time to go downstairs. I think that's everything from upstairs. Right? Yeah, I think so. Okay, let's go down. Oh, wait. Oh, I didn't go into here. An already searched there, yep. Yeah, now it's time to go down. Wrong way. Meant to get back to the lobby. Okay, that's closed, that's closed. Closed, closed. There's gotta be more, right? Right? I mean, there's gotta be a way to get down there, surely. Yeah, there must be. Hmm. How? Did I miss another way down? The only way down just leads to that dead end with a safe at the end of it. There's more going on here. There's something I'm missing. Right? There's gotta be a way in there. Maybe not. I don't think there's anywhere I haven't been. Perhaps there's a back door. Just feels like there's more. No, I think I came around the back, didn't I? I don't think there was a door back there. Oh, look at this. It's really pretty. Oh yeah, I learned how to put away my weapon, by the way. Forgot to try that until now. Turns out if you hold down the reload button, it puts it away. Yeah, let's see if there's another door around here. At least maybe one on the side? No. And I'm almost certain there's not one on the back. Nope. I feel like there's some way to turn on the power for this place, though. For over here. Dog meat, get out of my way. Maybe there's like a quest to come in here or something. Yeah, maybe there's a quest for this place. Well, I guess I'll leave it there. Let's get to a really pretty place, get a view. There we go. Let's end with that view. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to continue on to my goal and find whatever adventures await me along the way.